question started. So where were we? We have done this. Okay, object orientation we started, right? Second chapter. Object orientation. So last class what we have seen? Object orientation. So why Java is called object oriented? Because I mean it deals with object all the time. Okay. So whenever communication happens, it will happen using object through methods. Okay. That's why it is called object oriented programming language. Okay. And then we have seen, I mean, there is another reason why Java is called object oriented programming language. Why? Because it follows some set of rules. Okay. And what are those rules? Rules are nothing but we call those as a concepts. They also call oops concept. So what are the oops concept? Class. Okay. Class and object. What are the third one? Inheritance. Okay. Then polymorphism. Okay. And encapsulation. Okay, and what is the last one? Abstraction. This is the thing which we have seen last class. Okay, then what is inheritance? Inheritance is nothing but to reuse the code of your superclass. Okay, so whenever we'll have parent-child kind of relationship, we call this as a inheritance. Okay, and something we have seen it seems. What we have seen last class? Encapsulation we have seen, right? So encapsulation we have finished. So what is the advantage of inheritance? First is your code reusability. What is the second one? Polymorphism. Okay, polymorphism is one of the advantage of your inheritance. Okay, so then we have seen what is encapsulation. Putting boundary over your variable, right? so doing changes in your code without breaking the rule of others is called encapsulation. And we have seen two examples, Sagar and that Narendra, right? So Narendra was able to change the data of Sagar. Why? Because his data was not encapsulated. Okay. Now as soon as Sagar will encapsulate his data, what will happen? Narendra will not be able to change his data. Okay. So how to do the encapsulation? There are two step method which we use. Okay. First, make your variable private or protected, depending upon your requirement. But better private. Private is the best one. Then what will happen? Nobody can touch your variable basically. No? And what is the second step? We will have some accessors. Those are called getters and setters. No? So we will have some sort of accessors so that people will be able to change it. If they want to change it, they must come through method. No? So they should not directly change your data. Okay. So this is nothing but encapsulation. And why method? Because method is more in our control. Okay, variable is not in your control basically. No? So if you want to write some logic, can you write any logic in variable? You cannot write the logic. Where you write the logic? You write the logic inside method, right? So that's why if somebody wants to change your data, let them come through method. No? This is the mandatory thing. We should try to do that. Okay, you should not expose your data to outside anytime. No? So yeah, I think we were there only. Let's move ahead from that place. This one also we have seen. If I am boolean, then what is will be there. Normal will be get set, boolean will be is. Yes. Now let's try to understand. There are two very inheritance or anywhere. Okay. So there are two relationships which we have here. Okay. So first one is your has a. And second one is your is a. Correct, man. Has a. Whatever. That's what we are going to study now. No? Okay. So there are two type of relationship which we use in Java. One is called has a, another is called is a. first one, first we'll do this easier, then we'll come to Hazard, okay? Okay, I'll write one very small thing. Just tell me. I'll tell some of the statements. You have to tell me whether it is correct or not. Okay. So I'm having one of the super class called animal. Topmost will be what is the class name? Object. Object will always be there. Why? Because it is a supermost class. Okay. So I will tell some of the statements. You have to tell me it is true or false. Okay. So I'll tell. All dogs are animal, is it correct? Because all the dogs are animal, it is correct, okay? If I tell all animals are dog, is it correct? No. So you understood, right? Okay. So whenever we will have this sort of inheritance tree, okay? So all subclass are superclass, but all superclass are not subclass. Okay? So now tell me, if I need dog, if I need dog, can you give any animal to him? Any animal means horse? No. Got it, right? So suppose I need dog, can you give animal to him? No. If I need horse, can you give any animal to him? No. But if he'll tell I need one animal, you can give anything. I mean, you can give dog or horse or animal, anything. Got it, right? So if we need the superclass, you can give any subclasses, but if somebody needs subclass, you cannot give the superclass, because superclass might have some other value also. So in that case, we have to do some sort of casting. We have to do casting over there. Okay, so we'll see while going through. Okay, yeah. Now try to understand. I'll tell two more statements. You have to tell whether it's correct or not. Okay. So I'll tell dog is a animal. Is it correct? Dog is a animal. Is it correct? Yes, it is correct. Dog is an animal. Okay. If I tell animal is a dog, is it correct? No. Got it, right? So when I'm telling this statement, okay, so observe me what I'm telling. What is the statement I told? What statement I told? Dog is a animal. This is nothing but is a relationship. Okay. So what I'm telling is dog is a animal. Got it, right? Similarly, horse is a animal. But if I tell the reverse way, it is not correct. Na? Why? Because animal is not a dog. Got it, right? So that's right. So all the subclasses, is a superclass. Okay, so I mean, better what we can do, we can remove this all the subclasses. Subclass is a superclass. This is a relationship. Okay. So it's not about only, I mean, superclass or subclass. Okay. Sometimes we have some inheritance also, inheritance tree. Okay. Something like if I'm having some sort of, the class name is something like building planning. What is the interface name? Building planning. This is an interface basically. Okay. And some other class, maybe contractor. If you remember during our interface we have studied, right? Okay. So contractor implements building planning. Okay, so here what we are using implements, you know, so implements. Then also we can say contractor, okay, we'll have this is a, okay, building plan. Got it, right? Why? Because contractor implements building planning, right? So what we can say, contractor is a building plan. Got it, right? So this is nothing but easy only. So now to summarize it, okay, so what is easy? Easy is nothing but it is related to inheritance it is related to inheritance or interface. Okay, interface means implements. So what is EJ related to? EJ is related to inheritance or interface. Okay, so whenever we will have this kind of check, you can use, I mean, we'll do some example, it will more clear, right? So for time being, you understand whenever EJ relationship is there, it will be inheritance or interface. Okay, now try to understand. I'll have one more class, right? So suppose I'll have one more class called vehicle or car, right? I'm having one more class called car. Okay, so if I'll say car is a animal, is it correct? No. Why? Because car is not falling under our inheritance tree. Inheritance tree is here only. I mean, this is your inheritance tree. Okay, but car is not falling under our inheritance tree, right? So car is not a animal. Okay, so there is one method, na, by which we can check whether we are falling under EJ or not. Okay, so we will use one of the operator called instance of. What is the one called? Instance of operator. Use to check EJ relationship. So what is the operator we use? Instance of. Okay. And be very careful, this is an operator. What is operator means? What is operator means? Operator means, I mean, something like 4 minus 3 equal to 1. So this, what is this? Minus. Minus is an operator. Okay. Similarly, instance of is a operator. It is not method. If I will tell you what is equals is a method. Equals is a method. Okay. So whenever we use method, we use dot operator. You know? So how will you identify it is a method or operator? We use dot operator. You know? So if I am using dot operator, it is a method. If I am not using, then it is a operator basically. Okay. So how will you identify dot? It will be used with methods. Okay. Operator doesn't need dot. Okay, operator doesn't need this dot. Okay, so it will require operand. Okay, so operand, in your college you might have studied, right? So operator will be working on the operand, right? So whatever operands we have. So here 4 and 3, those are the data on which your this operator will work. Okay, so one of the special thing about this particular operator is operator will always fail during compile time if there is some problem. If there is some problem, it will always fail during compile time. It will never go till runtime. Compile time means you cannot compile it. Running is very far. So it's good that if you can find the problem during compile time only. Because when you run the code, there is some problem, then you will be in trouble, right? Where the problem is, okay? Again, you have to come and compile, many things will be there, okay? So if you are finding the problem during compile time only, it is best, okay? So we should try to get the problem as early as we can. That is better for us, right? So similarly, here also, I mean, if you get the problem in compile time, it is the best part which you can think of, basically, okay? So operator, when the problem will come during compile time only. So there is no, I mean, no problem in your runtime. So what is the operator we use? Instance of is the operator. Okay. Let's try to do a very simple example. We did not start Eclipse yet. Let's try to do a very simple example which will help you out to understand. I mean, what is easy relationship basically. Okay. So we'll try to use the same one. I mean, which we are discussing about animal, dog, horse, and car. Okay. Which one is our workspace? This one, right? Workspace daily. Okay, so this is encapsulation, right? So we want to do another project, or here only we can do. Where? Here only. Okay. So see here, we already created animal. Okay. We are having dog also. So dog extends animal. So what you can say? Dog is a animal. Got it, right? Yeah. Now let's try to check whether it is easy or not. Okay, so we'll create one more class. Okay, so what is the class name? Maybe we will create car. What is the class name? Car is the class name which we'll create. Okay, and we will create one more class called vehicle. What is the class name? Vehicle. So car is a vehicle. Okay, so what to do? How to do that is a here very simple. Go here, extends vehicle. That's all. That means car is a vehicle. If I do dog is a vehicle, is it correct? No. So how will you check? How to check instance of which we have discussed a little bit earlier. Okay, so we'll try to do that example here. We'll just comment it out. Okay, so let's try to create animal object equal to new animal. Okay, similarly I'll create dog object equal to new dog. Okay, similarly what is the other class? Vehicle object equal to new vehicle. What is the last one? Car object equal to new car. I mean, we created all those, objects. We had four classes. We had created the object of four classes. Okay. Now, if you want to check, you don't know. I mean, the code. Suppose you don't know the code. I mean, what is dog and all. Okay. If you want to check, let's try to do this. So how will we do this? We are having one of the operator. What is the operator called? Instance of. Okay. So I'll do dog object. Okay. Instance of animal. Animal. Is it correct? See, there is no problem. So dog object is instance of animal. Why it is coming? Because dog is a animal. Okay. So now if I have system.out.println, okay, so dog is a animal. Dog is not animal. So what should be the output it should give me? Tell me. Dog is a animal. Okay, we run it. Dog is an animal. Dog is an animal. No problem. Okay. Yeah. Now let's try to do this. Animal object. Tell me. Is it correct or not? Tell me. Is it correct or not? Animal is a animal. I am trying it. Is it correct? Animal is a animal. Yeah, animal is a animal. Right? Is there any problem? animal is a animal. Right? So let's try to run it. What is happening? Animal is a animal. Animal object is a animal. Okay. Yeah. Now let's try to do the other way. Now if I'll do vehicle. See? As soon as I'll write here vehicle object, then what will happen? It is failing. Are you able to see? There is some problem. Why this problem is, as I told, instance of is a operator. An operator will tell you the problem during compile time only. It will never go to runtime. So only it is failing here. Okay. So if you see here, what is the problem? Incompatible conditional operand type vehicle and animal. Okay. So why it is telling operand? Why it is telling operand? Because what is operand? Operand is nothing but based on those your operator will work. So as I told, 4 minus 3. Minus is your operator and 4 and 3 are the operand. Okay. So similarly here also these are the two operands are there. So why it is creating problem? Because vehicle is not a animal. But you are telling vehicle is an animal. What is that? So why it is failing during compile time? Because operator will always fail during compile time. It will not go to your runtime. Okay. Similarly, if I do car also, it will tell me there is some problem. See, there is some problem. Okay. But if I make this animal to vehicle, tell me, is it correct? Yeah, it's correct. Because car is a vehicle. Okay. So let's try to make it car. Car. When I do that, na car. Car is a vehicle. Okay. So car is a vehicle. No problem. But if I'll make this animal or maybe dog. Dog is a vehicle. Is it correct? Not correct. So it will fail during a compile time. Got it, right? So this is the thing which we discussed a little bit earlier. Domino's again, one free, buy one get one pizza. Every day free only. Okay, so yeah. Let's move to our slide. So what is EJ? That's what I told. Okay, Heze is also called, there are different names which we use here. Heze is also called, there is another name called composition. What is the another name of Heze? Composition or aggregation. So if anybody is asking what is composition or what is aggregation, all will boil down to the same name. What is that? Heze. Okay. And Heze means, it is inheritance. Inheritance or interface. Okay. So that's what I mentioned over the C. The concept of EJ is based on the class inheritance or interface implementation. What is the operator we use? Instance of operator will pass here. Okay. Something like car extends vehicle. So what we can say? Car is a vehicle. Bolero extends car. So what we can say? Bolero is a car. Indirectly, you can say Bolero is a vehicle also. Got it, right? What I'm going to say? So what I'm going to say here is, I mean, suppose we are having this this entrance tree, okay? So you are having a vehicle, okay? Then you are having car, okay? And you are having Bolero. So Bolero is a car. Car is a vehicle. Then what we can say? Bolero is a vehicle also, because that is super class, right? So you can say that is also correct, okay? So here you can do that. I mean, you can do that example, na? So you create one class called Bolero extends car, and if you will see Bolero, when you try to do instance of it, will be pass. Okay, why? Because it is falling under your tree only. Okay, yeah. Now let's try to go to this another relationship called Hasbro. Okay, yeah, now let's try to go to our here. I'll just write one thing, you will be able to understand what is Azure. Okay, so dog is a animal, okay, and suppose I am having one of the variable. What is the variable name? Owner. So try to understand. What I can say is, dog is a animal and dog has a owner. This is Hazel. Got it, right? So dog has a owner. Can you say dog is a owner? Owner will kill you. Got it, right? So you cannot say is a. Here what you can say, you must say has a. So now tell me what Heze is related to. What Heze is related to? Heze is related to instance variable. Heze is related to instance variable. Okay. So any class, if it is having some instance variable, then you can say class has a instance variable. Okay, and instance of will not work for has been. Okay, instance of will work only and only for is a. So that's what is mentioned over there. So what is Heze? Heze relationship are based on the uses or rather than inheritance. Okay, so it is related to the use, how you are using that particular class. Okay, not related to inheritance. There is nothing to do with inheritance in Heze. Okay, something like that. Understand? A horse is an animal, and horse has a halter. What is halter? I mean, something will be there, right, in your mouth. Okay, so that is called halter. So you cannot say horse is a halter. What do you say? Horse has a halter, basically. Na? So this is a question which typically get asked. Okay. So if we are comfortable with both is a and has a, which one you will choose? Okay, this is very typical question people will ask. Okay, so if you are able to go ahead with both of those implementation, is he also, has he also, which one you will prefer, basically? Okay, okay. So so sometimes people will ask, I mean, which is preferred, okay, or composition. Again, same meaning, and the question is same. Only thing is, here for easy I am using inheritance, and for has a we are using composition. Okay, similar to this, I mean, people will ask inheritance or aggregation, which I told, no? So if anyone asking this, then you should understand he is looking for the same thing. Okay. So tell me which is preferred, easy or has a? Has a or easy? Easy. Sure. Why? Why? Which is preferred? Okay. So if you are not able to go ahead, then you must use easy. There is no other way. Huh? But if you are able to go ahead with both of those, then has a is preferred over easy. So which is preferred? Has a. So has a, or what we talked about? Composition or aggregation. Preferred over and whatever inheritance or so has a is, or aggregation is preferred over inheritance. Okay, so try to understand. Try to understand. I will just give one very simple example. A is one of the super class. Okay, then B is one of the subclass and C is one of the subclass. Huh? So there are three classes, A, B, C. Okay. Now try to understand. I mean, you are able to go ahead with both. Okay. So I mean, even if I'll do like this, C, then I mean you will create one instance of instance. Huh? So this if I'll do like this, then also I'm able to go ahead with my implementation. Basically, instance variable. That is has a, right? As we discussed. Okay. So now try to understand. I mean, suppose B is having some sort of data. Right? So maybe the variable is I. Okay. And then J. Okay. And similarly, A is having some sort of variable called K and L. Maybe many variables. Okay, so now try to understand. I mean, if we'll do is a, what will happen? KL will come to B also. KL will come to C also. What is that? This is your EJ. Okay. But if I'll do HJ, what will happen? I don't need this, right? Okay, so what I'll do? I can directly do here B. Got it, right? So if I'll do this, what is the advantage? Try to understand. Because of this inheritance, what is happening? Some of the property will follow through your top to bottom. Got it, right? Maybe there are some properties which you don't require it. Those are coming unnecessarily, right? And property means it will unnecessarily take some of the spaces in your memory also. Because if you are creating some variable, right? So those will take space in your memory, right? Got it, right? So that's why if you are able to go ahead with both of those, EJ and HJ, always your HJ is preferred over EJ. Why? So that you can consume less memory. Otherwise, if you will make it EJ, what will happen? That will come through all the layers. I mean, are you able to understand? Even if people need it, don't need it, they will have to consume it basically, unnecessarily. Got it, right? So that is one of the problem with your inheritance basically. Okay? So that's why, I mean, EJ is always preferred over HJ. Why? Because if we go for inheritance, then some of the data flows through the inheritance tree unnecessarily means even if we don't need those. Correct, right? Even if you don't need, we have to, forcibly we have to consume those variables, okay? Because you cannot stop, this value should not come and that value should not come, okay? Which will consume more memory. But HJ or aggregation, what does that mean? HJ means, it is your own instance variable. It is your own instance variable, right? It is not following through your inheritance tree. That means what will happen? You will consume less memory, right? So we will consume less memory. In HJ. So that's why HJ is always preferred over EJ. Again, if you are able to go ahead with both of those. Okay? So this is the one. So that's what HJ is preferred over EJ. Okay. Yeah. Now let's try to move through. Okay. So does Java support multiple inheritance? No. We'll try to understand why it does not support basically. Okay. So what is multiple inheritance? Multiple inheritance is something but you are having one of the class called animal, okay, and you are having one class called vehicle, okay, and you are having one of the class called dog. Okay, what is multiple inheritance? Dog is extending animal also and vehicle also. This is called multiple inheritance. Okay, so if you see here, dog extends animal and you want to extend vehicle also here. So can you do this? You cannot do this. Why this problem is? Let's try to see. Syntax error token, something like this it is telling, right? So why this is telling? Because dog cannot extend two class. Okay, it will extend only one class. Okay, so this is multiple. This is multiple inheritance which Java does not support it. Okay, so it supports only multi-level or single inheritance. Okay, so Java So Java does not support multiple inheritance. It supports which sort of inheritance? Tell me. Multi-level or single inheritance. What is single inheritance? Only one, animal, dog. That's all. We don't have any other relation. What is multi-level? Animal, dog, then below that you are having dog, baby. Okay, so all those will be your multi-level. Vehicle, then car. This is your single inheritance. Okay, I mean only one arrow. Okay, and whenever we write, arrow for inheritance, the arrow will be full continuous line. Okay, what is continuous line means? Continuous line means, something like this, try to understand. No? Continuous line means, you will have like this. Full continuous line. Continuous line, whatever you will see, this is called extends. Okay. And if you are having this sort of line, dot dot dot, what is this? This is called implements. Okay. So what I told is, this will be, what is this for? Implements. Implements will have dot dot dot, okay, and if you are having this line, continuous line, what is that? This is called extends. So sometimes we have to draw some diagram, you know, class diagram, that time it will be useful basically. Okay. Now let's try to understand. First we understood there is no multiple inheritance in Java, but why? We'll try to explore it basically. Now the question is, how we have already seen? Okay, so now why? So typically any of the question, if you know what, how and why. So these are the three questions which should be asked, right? So if you know all the three, then you are perfect and you know everything. So anything, it's not about this multiple inheritance only. Any topic, whenever you will choose, just get three answer. What, how and why, that's all. Okay, so let's start to understand why. So let's read it out. This is the statement which was given by Gosling, basically. Who is Gosling? Your founder of Java, so GSN, if you remember, Gosling, Sheridan, Norton, those are the three persons, right? So now let's start to understand. So this is the exact statement which was given by Gosling when they were releasing this Java. Okay, so what is the statement? Java omits many rarely used, poorly understood, confusing features of C++ that in our experience bring more grief then benefits. What is grief? Grief means problems, basically. No? This primarily consists of operator overloading. So operator overloading is one of the very confusing feature in C++. Okay. So only they have removed it. Okay. What is the another confusing feature? Multiple inheritance. So that is also very confusing. Okay. That's why they have removed this, basically. No? So whenever they were releasing this language Java, that time what was their goal? They wanted to have the language as very simple. Got it, right? So they wanted to have the language as simple. And they thought if you'll have multiple inheritance, then people will not be able to understand it. It will become very complicated. Okay. So that's why what happened? They have removed that particular feature only, basically. Okay. So what is the first reason why they have removed this multiple inheritance? Because Java creator wanted to make the language very simple. Okay, and what was happening? This multiple inheritance, and operator overloading were making the language complicated or complex. So these are the two features which I mean C++ people will not be able to understand basically, you know? So that's why they have removed this. So as to make the language simple. So this is their goal. I mean, they wanted to make the language simple, okay, and they were thinking this will create a lot of problems while going through, so they have removed this feature basically. Okay, yeah, now so that's what I mean. So Java supports only single inheritance, no multiple inheritance Java, although it supports multi-level inheritance. Okay, and the second so the reason why Java creators choose not to allow multiple inheritance is that it can become quite messy. What is messy? Messy means messed up language. Okay, they don't want to messed up basically. Okay, and what is the another problem? Deadly diamond update. Okay, so what is the another problem? Deadly diamond update. This is also very typical interview question people will ask. Okay, first they will ask, does Java supports multiple inheritance? If you say no, then he will stop asking question there only, because he will come to know you don't know, right? Okay, if you say yes, then they will ask why. Got it, right? So why will be asked if you know that it is there or not. Okay, so this is the step. First they will ask, what is multiple inheritance, is there in Java? If you say yes, then why it is not there. That's what the question will be asked. Okay, if you tell wrong, they will stop asking their own answer. Okay, so yeah, now what is deadly diamond update? Let's try to understand. Okay, so actually I think I told wrong until later later. Okay, so what I told, multiple inheritance, if somebody will tell yes, then it's good. I mean, they will come to know that you don't know. If you say no, then they will ask why no. So yeah, what is deadly diamond of death problem? Let's try to understand this particular diagram, then we will be able to understand basically. Okay, so see, I mean, there are two things, you know? One is your horse, okay, another is some sort of bird, I mean penguin or something, I'm not sure, you know? So try to understand. I mean, so this is the diagram, you know? So this is your horse, this is your penguin, okay. And there are some properties which are common in both the places, here also. Got it, right? So what is happening, try to understand. Suppose, I mean, a horse is having four legs, okay, now your penguin will have two legs. Got it, right? So both the properties are, I mean, different in both the classes. Got it, right? So now what will happen, the subclass will be confused, right? From where to take the property, whether to take from horse or penguin. So some sort of confusion is coming, right? Here is 4, here is 2. So which one to take? Got it, right? So that's why this is called deadly diamond death problem basically. Huh? So that means what, you are confused which property to take from your superclass. Okay. So similar to this, I mean now we are having two level of inheritance. Okay, suppose if you have multi-level here. Okay, so what I'm to say is, I mean, there will be some scenario. Try to understand. A is there, okay, A is class, B is there, C is the class, okay, then D is the class, then E is the class, okay, and F is the class, okay. What he is doing? F is extending C, D, E, B and A. Got it, right? Now F will be confused, right? From where to take property? Whether to take from C, D, E or B or A. Got it, right? So this is nothing but this is called deadly diamond of death problem. I mean, you are not sure from where to take the property. Okay, so that's all. Now we are having only three level. Might be here something is there. Okay, F G. Okay, some sort of G H I. You don't know. I mean, we might have multiple levels also, right? So now he is gone. I mean, this F is gone. I mean, we don't know from where to get the property. This is called deadly diamond of death. So that's why I mean no multiple inheritance in Java. Okay. So what is where we were? We'll just conclude it. Where it is? Okay. Okay. So if we have multiple inheritance, then subclass will be confused from where to take the properties. As it has got many superclasses. Got it, right? Because subclass is very much confused because it has got many superclasses. Okay. So superclass will have many properties which might be common in various places. Okay, and in case superclasses will have some properties common. Suppose some of the property in this case, as we talked about, number of legs. So this sort of property might be common in many superclasses, right? Then subclass is fully confused which superclass to follow. To get the property. Okay, so something like if you're working for any of the company. Okay, so nobody wants to have more than one supervisor. If you're having more than one boss, what will happen? You have to obey all of them, right? So you're gone. You can't work properly because you cannot satisfy everybody, right? If you're having three bosses, electricity, I think this. So electricity also, I mean, agreeing with my words. Okay. So what happens if you are having more than one boss? What will happen? You have to satisfy all of those boss, right? So it should be very tough for you, basically. No? So that's why always we try to have only one supervisor or maybe only one boss. Okay. Similarly here also, I mean, we will have only one superclass. Okay. We will not have multiple superclasses. So multiple superclass means if you can have multi-level. I mean, if your boss is this, his boss is this. This is fine, no problem, because his boss will talk to that guy. Otherwise, if you have more boss, then what will happen? You have to talk to him also. It will be creating problem for you, basically. Okay. So yeah. So this is nothing but what is this? This is nothing but deadly diamond of death problem. This is nothing but deadly diamond of death. So always, if anybody will ask about this multiple inheritance, what you should do, you should draw some set of diagram, this sort of diagram, and you should tell, I mean, some properties here, all the places. Then the subclass, submost class will be confused. Okay. So always draw some sort of diagram. Okay. So that's why this, to avoid what is the problem, deadly diamond of death problem. Okay. Yeah, polymorphism will start tomorrow. Okay. So tomorrow, what to do? I mean, polymorphism we are supposed to start today, right? Okay. Anyway, one day extended, you do more and Google about the polymorphism.